The adaptations of Stephanie Meyer's Twilight Saga were hit with ridiculously high fan expectations, especially when it came to their looks. From the impossible beauty and sparkles of the Cullen family vampires to the papery skin textures of the Volturi guardsmen to the animal strength of the Wolfpack members, Meyer's attention to descriptive detail meant the cinematic versions had to be perfectly faithful to keep fans happy. While some of the characters came to life just as written, others were practically unrecognizable. Here's how the cast of the Twilight Saga should really look. Edward Cullen. The casting of Robert Pattinson for the role of Edward Cullen was based on more than just his striking appearance. But that aspect was certainly supreme, considering Stephanie Meyer probably wrote out her thesaurus in coming up with synonyms to describe those golden eyes the character had in book form and on screen. The Robsession that followed Pattinson's turn in the role proved that he was good-looking enough, at least.
What's impressed you the most about him so far?
I think he's really handsome.
He also had the Cullens' shared sullen complexion, deep eyeshadows, and auburn bouffant to match the role, in the first installment at least. However, he was a little too old and underdressed for the role of a boyish gent who looked like he'd just finished shooting a commercial for hair gel. Instead of wearing outfits like hoodies and grandpa coats, he should have been dressed to the nines. And Pattinson could hardly pass as 17 Eternal, the way the character was described. Jacob Black. Taylor Lautner went through a stunning bodily transformation throughout the Twilight Saga, rising from an ordinary kid to a chiseled man-child that towered over Bella. To achieve the bulk, Lautner packed on pounds of muscle to match that growth spurt, and he also kept his teeth in tip-top shape to match Jacob's brilliant smile and certainly had the pretty face Bella described so well. But he still never quite had the domineering posture of his literary counterpart, and his wig game was way off. As the book described him, he looked 14, maybe 15, and had long, glossy black hair pulled back with a rubber band at the nape of his neck.
And let's face it, I am hotter than you.
Carlisle Cullen. The good doctor slash vampire patriarch Carlisle Cullen was pretty much all wrong. Peter Facinelli did a decent job portraying all the requisite calm and compassion of the good doctor's personality, but he was much, much older than the character's described age. In the books, he could barely pass for being in his 20s, but Facinelli was 35 when he first tackled the role. The book describes Carlisle as being young, blonde, but also pale and tired-looking, with circles under his eyes. Jane. As the grinning, sinister twin Jane, Dakota Fanning sported sleek blonde hair and plenty of eye makeup to highlight her bright red eye color. And while the Volturi costuming she wore might have been right, she was still far off from the tiny and androgynous vamp she was described as in the books, with lank, pale brown hair trimmed short and dull crimson irises.
It's not often we're rendered unnecessary.
Charlie Swan. Many rainier beers for the casting directors who picked Billy Burke for the role of Chief Charlie Swan, the lovable and sometimes naive dad to young Bella. His kind brown eyes and everyday man exterior were exactly what the story ordered, and he was just the right level of awkward and humble as the books described. As Bella described Charlie in the books, his brown eyes crinkled around the edges, and when Charlie smiled, it was easier to see why he and my mother had jumped too quickly into an early marriage. Even so, that mustache came out of nowhere, and he didn't have the same curly hair his character was said to have in the books. Ah, well. Nearly perfect, then. Alice Cullen. Ashley Green's look as Bella's fashion-savvy best friend Alice Cullen was pretty, petite, and just as sprightly as expected for the character. However, there was still a lot missing from her appearance in the role. Green's mane was cropped short, but it was hardly the goth pixie hairdo book readers may have imagined for her after reading the book, which described it as short, inky hair in a halo of spiky disarray around her exquisite elfin face. Green was also obviously older than 17 and certainly wasn't as waifish as described. Arrow. Actor Michael Sheen has said before that even his twihard daughter had some trouble picturing him in the role of Arrow, because the character somehow resonated as a bald vampire in many fans' minds. But it was still pretty accurate with his blazing red eyes and long black locks. As described in the books, though, Arrow's skin was translucently white, like onion skin, his eyes were supposed to be clouded and milky, and his hairline should have been a little less pronounced. Bella Swan. The casting of Kristen Stewart in the role of Bella Swan, the clumsy human who has a chance encounter with sleepy town destiny, was remarkably on point, especially once she threw in her brunette extensions and some chocolate brown contacts. She was pale, spindly, and just as awkward as described in human form. Lip biting and excessive size aside, this one was about as accurate as it could be, even though a lot of readers might have imagined themselves as Bella instead of Stewart. Come on, could you blame us? Thanks for watching! Click the Nikki Swift icon to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Plus, check out all this cool stuff we know you'll love, too!